Are you sleepy? This strange battle is the reason. Our bodies are being torn in half, depending on the battle between the biological clock and the social watch. And that is why you are sleepy. In your head, somewhere between the eyes, there is a very small brain area. It contains only about 20,000 cells, out of a total of 100 billion of the brain. Small but martial, because this area of the brain can interfere almost everything in the body, hormones, internal organs, cognitive processing, and even the sleep cycle. It is a supranational nucleus, but to the average person, we know it by a different name, the biological clock. In his book, Professor Till Roneberg from the Institute of Medical Psychology at the Ludwig Maximilians University in Munich, Germany, presented a discovery of this watch. Accordingly, the body's biological clock is closely related to the light from the sun. Roneberg tested this by putting some people in the dark pit, with no light. The results show that their biological clocks gradually change. They imagine a longer day, stay awake longer, and sleep longer. However, it is interesting that blind people also encounter this phenomenon if they are locked up in the dark, because despite not seeing anything, the eyeball sends information about the light to the brain. Only when the victim has no more eyes will the concept of time disappear. Biological clock and social clock. We understand that each person has a biological watch, and it operates in the light of the sun. But Roneberg points to a reality in the modern world. We have another watch to follow. It is worn on the hand, mounted on the wall, put on the phone, or a lot of other things and decide the time we have to wake up, move, work. It is a social watch, as Roneberg calls it, and seems to win the battle between the two types that belong to it. But more importantly, Roneberg warns that the world's dependence on the social watch is putting mankind at risk. Perhaps you have heard of the term jet lag, referring to the tiredness of the body due to time zone differences after long flights. And with Roneberg, people face the same difference every day, between social clocks and what the body really wants. He called it a social jet lag. Victims of social jet lag tend to smoke more, drink more beer, and always crave for caffeine. At the same time, their bodies are at risk for high hormonal imbalances, altered emotions, and difficulty concentrating. That does not take into account the risk of obesity. If you're a bit overweight, it's probably because life is against the clock, Roneberg said. And in fact, 2/3 of the population is waking up in the middle of a real human sleep cycle. The way the world works today is causing many of us to wake up very late, and of course this is not good. The clock in your brain wants you to sleep late, get up late, but social clocks do not allow that. Depending on the nature of the job, you must be at work before 8 a.m., which means waking up and getting ready at 6 a.m., as a result, your real time zone is deviated. According to Roneberg, we are witnessing jet lag every day without having to go far. From the time you wake up, your time zone has been deflated. And so the jet lag goes on, from home to work, and it has serious consequences for the economy. Social clocks require a lot of productivity, biological clocks are still looking for a quiet mattress, and we have to find a balance between them. Bad results from time zone differences. In Roneberg's Internal Time, he mentions the consequences that occur when your time zone is not compatible with your body. The first is fatigue, and then decreases concentration, cognitive ability, and motor skills. Then the digestive hormone is deflected. And then the internal organs are not synchronized, leading to the whole system is deflected. In fact, people have never known the time zone deviation until the jet is invented. We do not even know what the time zone is before creating the train. Previously, if you sail along the Atlantic coast, your biological clock will have time to adjust. When there is a clock, the time is set according to the sun. But when traveling by train in countries like the US, you will have to reset the clock continuously. So, in 1884, the concept of a new time zone, in which the Earth was divided into 24 different time zones. But since then, the relationship between man and the sun has become weaker. People are increasingly time zone. People's sleep is getting shorter, and that may be the advantage to making money in this age. The problem is that with that, we wake up very late and wake up very early, which, of course, will disturb the biological clock and deviate from the social time zone. But why? According to Ronnie Burke, that is the consequence of modern technology. We spend all day in the office, exposed to a light weaker than the sun. Night down, we still sit in the room, under a much stronger light than moonlight. The difference, in many respects, is enormous. Biometric timers no longer receive the same clear signal. While it is true for the operation of the body, these wall clocks do not have much meaning. And that is the reason for the growing time zone difference between body and society. Results. What is the problem here? We really need to find a way to respect our biological clock, says Ronnie Burke. Our body can learn how to adapt, but it needs to be guaranteed sleep time. For Ronnie Burke, the ideal figure for sleep is 8 hours, night, and you have to make that number enough. Can use blindfolds to prevent artificial lighting, or to remove work, technology before resolving eyes closed.